गुड मॉर्निंग 11 क्लास, दिस इज ललित नाथ, वेलकम टू माई चैनल। एज यू नो स्टूडेंट, इन अ लास्ट वीडियो वी वर ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर नंबर फर्स्ट। द चैप्टर नेम इज द कंसेप्ट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स एंड द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ स्टैटिक्स इन द इकोनॉमिक्स। एंड इन दिस टॉपिक वी वर ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड एंड इन लास्ट वीडियो इन अ पार्ट वन वी वर ऑलरेडी अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट, द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ द इकोनॉमिक्स। In this video, I will teach you and we will discuss about the features and character sketch of the statics. What is features of the statics? First of all, we have to understand. Before this, student, in last video, I was explaining you what is the meaning of statics. Once again, we will revise that definition. Statics are the numerical statement of the facts in any department of inquiry placed in the relation to each other. So this is a statics. In that thing, we are numerical. We are comparing the numerical data with each other, and we can find out a particular solution. In this video, we are going to understand the concept of features of statics. First feature is to be aggregates of the fact. Aggregate means sum total of numerical facts, because of a single number does not continue a statics. A single number has no meaning in the statics. No conclusion can be drawn from it. In a single number we can't find out the solution. So we have to, if you want to compare anything, first of all we have the data should be aggregate. It is only the aggregation number of the fact is called statics. As the name can be compared and conclusion can be drawn from them. For example, suppose a student get marks or get percentage, suppose in 10th class, suppose to 90%. It is not a solution. If you have a 2% result, one person have a 90%, another person have a 98%. Now in this data, in this figure, you can compare to each other. You can compare two marks with each other. So this thing is a comparable. In short, we can say that aggregate of facts is applicable in the stats. Without aggregation, the numbers is not work. So we have to, if you want to solve any kind of problem in the statics, so first of all, we have the data should be aggregate. Number second is to be numerically expression. Means every problem, economic problem should be in the way of numerical expression. Without numerical expression, we can't be find out any kind of solution. Statics are expressed in terms of numbers. Qualitative aspect like small, big, tall, heavyweight, tallest person, smart, intelligent, these kind of terms are not work in this data. We have to write everything in the term of numerical. Second thing, suppose Irfan Pathan is taller than Sachin, is shorter. These kind of stats is not working in the these kind of data is not working in the stats. So however, if you say that the height of Irfan Pathan is to be 6.2 and the height of Sachin Tendulkar is to be 5.4, it is applicable, because of now we can compare. Okay, now we can compare the data to data, and before that statement, the Irfan Pathan is taller than Sachin Tendulkar. This is not comparable, because of in this the data is not find out. Okay, in such a way, these kind of numerical data should be expressed by the economics. So that's why we can solve the economic problem. Now the third thing is to be affected by the multiplicity of the causes. So the stats the stats are affected by the multiple causes. Statics are not affected by any single factor, but are influenced by many factors. Many more factors are influenced or the affected to the statistical data. Now the point is to be, had they been affected by one factor alone, then by removing them, factors are would be lose of their significance. You know, if we have only one factors, we can change it, we can remove it, but the factors are very, very much. Okay, so that's why we can't able to remove that factors. And the for instance, the 30% rise in the price may have been due to several causes, like the reduction in the supply. Suppose if you are saying that the price of anything is reduces by the 5%, 30%, it may be very, very, very high causes. You know, that may be a very big, so many causes. For example, like reduction in the supply, increase in the demand, shortage of the power, rise in the wages, and rise in the taxes, etc. So these many factors can be affected. So we are not able to remove that factors. Now, fourth one is your reasonable accuracy, means that a reasonable degree of accuracy must be kept in a view while collecting statistical data. If you are collecting the data, we have to make sure that the data is to be accurate, means right, you know, good. Now this data is depend on the purpose of the investigation, its nature, size, and available resources. Now fifth one is your planned in relation to each other. Such numerical along with B will be called statistical R, mutual related to each other or a comparable. Data must be comparable. Suppose if I took a test or a class test of the economics, so the all the numerical marks must related to economics. That marks are not related with the business or accountancy. If the marks are that, so we cannot be compared. Every number must be related to one thing. Suppose that marks are related to economics, means economics. Suppose all the marks are related to business, means business. So then we can compare to each other. Otherwise, we can't be able to comparable. Unless they have the quality of the comparison, they can't be called statistical. If the quality is not good, so we can't be comparable. Okay, so the quality must be good. For example, if it is stated that Ram is a 40-year-old, Mohan is 5 feet tall, Shohan has a 60 kg of weight, then these numbers will not be called as a statistical data, because of every data are different. First thing, Ram is 40 year is a different thing. Mohan is 5 feet tall is a different thing. Sohan has a 60 kg weight is different. Every data must be a same nature. If we are talking about the age, so the every data given as a age group. If we are talking about the height, so everybody info data is given in the height form. If we are comparing in the form of kg or weight, so every data should be in weight or related to weight. So then we can compare, or then we can find out a particular solution from that. Now the point is to be, six is to be predetermined purpose. Statics are collected with some predetermined objective. Any information collected without any definite purpose will only be a numerical value and not statics. If data pertaining to the farmers of the villages is collected, there must be some predetermined objective. Without predetermining goal, if you are collecting any data, that data is useless. Because of when your objective is decided according to your objective, according to your goal, we are collecting any kind of data, that data will work. That result will be effective. That result will be efficient. We can conclude that that in a good position of that result of that that questions. So data must be your goal is to be predetermined, because of after setting a goal, if you are collecting the data, that will be more effective and more valuable. Suppose for example, whether if some predetermined objective, whether the statistics are collected for the purpose of knowing their economic position or a distribution of land among them, or their total population, or for any other purpose, all these objectives must be predetermined, and according to their predetermined goal and objective, you will find out data accordingly. Okay, friend. Now the point number 7 is to be enumerated or estimated. Okay, estimation means, you know, forecasting. You may say that assumption. Statistics may be collected by the enumeration, or the same be estimated. If the field of investigation is vast, the procedure of estimation may be helpful. For example, 1 lakh people attended the rally addressed by the Prime Minister in the Delhi and 2 lakh in Mumbai. Suppose, student, many of time we are assuming that the estimated data, and that data must be related to objective, or that data must be valid. These statistics are based on the estimation. This data is related supposed to estimation, and as against it, if the field of inquiry it is limited, the enumeration method is appropriate. For example, it can be verified by the enumeration whether 20 students are present in the class or 10 workers are working in the factory. This kind of data is to be verified, because of the data is to be less. But when the figures are very high and we are not able to count it, so in that condition we are estimated data assumed. Okay, if the target is to be less, in that case we can verify and we can count that data. Okay, now the point number 8 is to be collected by a systematic manner. Statistics should be collected in a systematic manner. Before collecting them, a plan must be prepared. No conclusion can be drawn from statistics collected in a haphazard manner, as a assumption basis. For instance, data regarding the marks secured by the student of the college without any reference to the class subject class or a subject examination, or a student or a college without any reference, the class and subject examination or a maximum marks extra will lead to be no conclusion. First of all, we will take a test or a class test, then we will find out a highest number of a student. So we can give a highest number because of it is reference, because of he given a test. We concluded that all numerical data can't be called as a statistics, but all these statistics are called a numerical data. This is a very important question or a statement. This question is asked by your subject teacher or examiner in the paper. Is that all the numerical data can't be called as a statistics, but all the statistics are called as a numerical data. Okay, friends. I hope, student, you got my point. In the last video, in the next video, we will understand we will teach with a new topic. So, student, please focus it, and you have to learn this point. Okay, student. See you again in the next video. Thank you. Bye bye.